Hey everyone, it's Noah and welcome back to the channel. There are so many Amazon softwares out there and it's almost impossible to keep track of what's on the market. That's why a lot of my recommendations come from sellers who are larger than me and I just look at what softwares they're using. So one of the people that I look up to, his name is Scott Needham. He's a really big Amazon seller and he came out with a software that's supposed to help with product research and analyzing Amazon data. Now, I made a video about the software a few weeks ago, and the software is called Smart Scout Pro. And during that video, I went over an overview and I showed you a couple of the features. So since that video, a lot of people have been asking me to make a video showing how I use the software in my business. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how I use Smart Scout to find suppliers, look at competitors, and grow my business. Now, I do want to preface this video by saying that Smart Scout is pretty expensive. The starter plan is $97 a month, or the annual plan is $897. However, I do think it is worth every penny, especially if it's going to help you if you are doing wholesale or wholesale dropshipping. So let's go over the first way that I use Smart Scout Pro. We're going to go into the categories tab, and from here, we're going to be able to find brands and companies that we can use as suppliers. So the way that I do this is you can choose what category you want to go ahead and find that brand in. I usually like to sell home and goods. I also sell a bit of toys and grocery. So I'm going to go ahead and select home and kitchen. From there, you can go ahead and you can enter in your total product count. So usually I like to have brands that have around more than 5 products. And then the monthly revenue doesn't really matter right now because I can always sort through that later. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit search, and Smart Scout is going to go ahead and bring up the brands that are hitting this criteria. So now Smart Scout has found every brand in this category that meet this criteria. Now comes the part where we're going to filter through this in order to get the results that we want. The first thing that I'm going to edit is the Amazon in-stock rate. You'll see that it says this is based off of the past 90 days across all of the products. So here, for these products, I'm going to look for items that Amazon was in stock 70% or less because I am not looking to only find FBA products. I want to find FBM products because I am primarily dropshipping. So I'm going to go here and inside the filtering, I'm going to hit the max and I'm going to look for items with 70% or less. Now you'll see all of the items are going to be 70% or less for Amazon in stock rate. The next category is the average number of sellers. So here it's going to be the average number of sellers on these brands listings. So this brand right here has an average number of 1.4 sellers per a listing. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to set a minimum of 2 sellers. This is going to get rid of all of the private label brands or all the brands that either sell it themselves or only designate one seller on their listings. The average selling price really depends on your preference for your products. I tend to sell higher priced items. However, if you do sell items that are under $20 or it doesn't really matter to you as long as it's profitable, you can leave this category untouched or you can edit it how you want. For the monthly estimated revenue, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to sort it by the most. So this way I can see the biggest brands that are in this category. Next, I'm going to set a limit. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to set the min and I want to do at least $10,000 a month. For the next column, we have the average review rating for the products on that brand. So I'm going to go ahead and set the minimum to 3. I don't want to be selling products with low reviews. Usually that leads to problems or returns. So this way I set it to 3 for the entire brand. For the total product count, we've already set that to 5. You can go ahead and adjust it here. Usually I don't like to adjust it. It doesn't really matter to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave that blank. For the average number of FBA sellers, again, it really depends on what you're looking for. So because I am primarily targeting items that are FBM, I can go ahead and I can adjust this. Now, what's important to know is that if you adjust this, it's also important to adjust the average number of sellers. So let's say I am trying to find items that have primarily FBM sellers. I can go ahead and set a max for the average number of FBA sellers. Let's say I set the max to 2, and then I go over to the average number of sellers, and I go ahead and I set the max, or I set the minimum to, let's say, 10. So here, it's going to find items with at least 8 FBM sellers. Next, you have the dominant seller name. So you'll see Amazon mostly sells these brands. You can go ahead and you can remove Amazon or not. Sometimes it doesn't really bother me because Amazon might only be selling some of the listings while a brand might have 1,000 items and there are a lot of other listings that I can potentially sell on. Next, you have the brand score. I don't really do anything with this. I've played around with it, but personally, it doesn't really matter to me. Lastly, you have the notes category, which you can go ahead and enter in any notes you want to take. So with those criteria in place, we now have a couple of brands that have met our criteria. So let's go ahead and take a look at one of them and then we'll see what this brand has to offer and if we can find if it has a wholesale program And if the brand does not have a wholesale program, then we can go ahead and ask them if they have any distributors that they work with, or we can go ahead and search up on Google to see if we can find any distributors that sell this brand. So the way that this works is you can either click this name right here, and it's going to bring up the page on Amazon, or you can go ahead and click right here, and then it's going to show you the brand information within Smart Scout. So it's going to pull up all the product listings, and now you can actually sort through the items for this brand within Smart Scout Pro. So now let's take a look at the stats for this brand. The Amazon in-stock rate is 45%, so Amazon is not covering this brand too much. The average number of sellers is 2.7, so there are more than one seller on this listing. Then we have the average selling price, which is a bit low, but the monthly revenue is almost $1 million a month. The average size of the product is not too big, and then the average review rating is 4.4. So overall, their items are very good, especially for a brand that has over 500 items. So we can go ahead and now we can take a look at this brand. So within Smart Scout, we can also go ahead and take a look at the items. So here I have it sorted by revenue. This is their best-selling item. We can go ahead and pull that up on Amazon as well. And you also have a tab for the sellers. Here we can go ahead and take a look at who is selling this brand. So we see that Amazon is the dominant seller. Then you have Amazon Warehouse. So Amazon makes up probably around 50%, if not a little bit more. Then we have Picker City. We have MI Shopping Deals, Express Brands. But it looks like the top sellers are not the actual brand themselves. So what I want to do now is I want to search up the brand on Google and see if I can look up to see if they have a wholesale account or if they have a way to reach out to them to ask for distributors. So the name of the brand was Primitives by Kathy. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to search this brand name on Google. And I do see something right here that says wholesale store. So that might mean that they sell wholesaler, and it says Primitives by Kathy is a home decor wholesaler offering a wide range of home decor items. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So we go to their website and we want to find a wholesale program or information about how to join them as a wholesaler. So let's go ahead and take a look. Looking at the footer of their website, I'm looking for a way to apply for a wholesale account. So I see register, and let's see my account. Welcome to the new primitivesbykathy.com. So here we can go ahead and create a wholesale account. So we just found out that they are a wholesaler and we found a way to apply. So now it would be as simple as going ahead and looking at the application, contacting them, asking what would be required in order to become a retailer for them, and then opening up a wholesale account and selling their products on Amazon if we are allowed. The other great thing about Smart Scout is that it saves all of your information in previous tabs. So if you want to go back to your brands that you were looking at, you can go ahead right here and click brands. But if you want to go back to the other brands that you were looking into before, you can just click that brand and you can toggle between the products and the sellers, and you can sort through the information however you want to. Additionally, you also have the option to export it as an Excel file to take the data, and you can use that to sort through in Excel, or you can go ahead and upload it to other softwares like Keepa. The great thing about the categories tab is that you can actually save your grid filters. So this way you can save it as a preset and you can always go back to it. So the next tab that we're going to be talking about is going to be the brands tab. Now, this I don't really use too much, but what I mainly use it for is I use it to find brands that have been listed by other sellers that are misspelled or are a little bit different. So for example, let's take a look at the brand CTW. They are a wholesaler and they dropship. On Amazon, all of their listings were created by third-party sellers. However, not everyone used the same name. So some of the listings are underneath the brand CTW Home Collection. However, some of the listings are just under the brand CTW. This makes it harder to find all of the brand's products, especially because they are being listed by third-party sellers. So one thing that I'll do is I'll search up the brand's name and I'll see what Smart Scout comes up with. So you'll see that they found CTW Home Collection, but they also found CTW, CTW, JW, CTW Home. So there are a few brands that match this, and we can go ahead and take a look through this to see which listings or which of these brands are actually CTW products that I can potentially sell. What this also allows you to do is it also allows you to find the brands that you're currently working with. So let's say I was selling CTW on Amazon. I can go ahead and I can take a look at all of the brand's listings, find the ones that are most profitable, as well as I can also find my competitors straight through Smart Scout. So how would I use this information in practice? So I have the brand right here. What I can do is I can look at the full brand info. So let's take a look at that. And if you look at the full brand info, it's going to show you all the items and you can sort by which items are the most profitable. So this is a pretty good feature. However, I don't really use Smart Scout for that. That's more Scan Unlimited's purpose. So I can use Smart Scout to take a look at the products that CTW is selling, and I can sort it by revenue. I can sort it by the number of sellers. I can also go ahead and I can sort it by the in and out of stock, which is a really cool feature. However, what I mainly use Smart Scout for is to look at my competitors and see what other products they're selling. So I can go ahead and I can take a look at all of the sellers that are selling CTW Home Collection products. And now I can find the ones that are the biggest sellers and see what other brands, what other products are they selling, and I can actually snipe other sellers. So for example, we have a couple of sellers right here. We have Sunshine Megastore, and their number of offers are 63, and they have a monthly revenue estimate of about 16,000, and their brand percentage, so they cover about 15% overall of this brand. They're getting a pretty decent chunk of this brand, so they're probably a pretty big seller on Amazon. So let's go ahead and take a look at their Amazon store, as well as we can also go ahead and we can view their seller information. Now on their seller information, we can look at their brands that they're selling, as well as other offers that they have on Amazon, which allows us to find other brands that they're selling. And then we can go ahead and contact those brands. We can also see what are their best selling products and see if we can get access to those products. So there is a lot that you can do with Smart Scout, and this is only scratching the surface. So from their offers that Smart Scout is showing us, we can see right here also the buy box percentage. So from this listing, they're getting about $35,000 a month because they have 99% coverage of the buy box. And we can see the brand is Gifts and Decor. So what I would do is I would just search up this brand on Google, see if they have a wholesale program, and see if I can find this item to see if I can sell it. So we can also go ahead and take a look at this item on Amazon and see how many other sellers are there. Then we can also go ahead and take a look at their listing or at their information on Amazon. So we see right here their reviews, their product, where they're based out of. And we can also take a look at their information. And then we could also take a look at this item information on Amazon. So the great thing about Smart Scout is that it easily allows you to go from one data point to the next, and it flows very well. So the other tab on this page is brand coverage. Here you can go ahead and see the brands that this seller is selling. You can see the number of offers, the monthly revenue, and then overall their brand coverage of this brand. So for Gifts and Decor, this seller right here is about 35% on all of the listings. And here we have Colonial Tin Works as well as CTW, which is the one that we found them. So they are doing about 15% as we just said. So out of all of this, you can go ahead and snipe and target the brands that they are selling, find their most profitable brands and find their most profitable sellers. The last tool that I want to talk about is going to be Seller Map. Now, I think this is a really cool tool. However, it's been a little bit slow going on me implementing this on how to use it in my business. So two ways that I've been using it in my business is I've been looking at sellers that are in my vicinity and seeing what they're selling, as well as I've also been using it to find some wholesale suppliers. So what I'll do is I'll find a wholesale supplier, and let's say that supplier is located in Texas. I will go ahead and I will look up the map right here in Texas. So let's say they're based in Houston. So I would go ahead and I would find Houston on the map, and I would try and find their location to see if that supplier is selling on Amazon. This way I know, am I going to be competing against that supplier? So that's one way that I've been using it. Really hasn't been the most effective. The other way is I've been using it to go ahead and look at my competitors. So let's say I am doing wholesale. I can go ahead and I can find people within my region. So I live in New Jersey. I can go ahead and I can take a look at Jersey and see what sellers are selling nearby. I can take a look at them and I can see what products they are selling. Now here you'll see that this one right now is a private label seller, or they are just selling one brand, but you can use this and there's so many possibilities that you can use with this software. Plus they are releasing features every single week. So that's an overview of a couple of ways that I use Smart Scout Pro in my business. Now we only covered the seller and the competitor research side. However, there is also a lot that you can use it for with product research and just using it to find products to sell, especially from competitors and specific brands. However, like I said, the great thing about Smart Scout is that it gives you all the data off of Amazon. So it allows you to go ahead and access all of this Amazon data almost instantaneously off of Amazon, and you can just export that data and you can manipulate it and use it in other softwares like Keepa or Scan Unlimited or Tactical Arbitrage, whatever you are using it for. As always, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to go ahead and smash the thumbs up button. Also, let me know if you have any video suggestions or anything that you'd like to see in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.